Hi, cool. So you've just recently written Fast Asleep, which is a fantastic book, full of advice, recipes, and scientific research, about why we need sleep. Why is sleep so important, and what are the long-term health effects of poor sleep?
Sure. So there are different components to sleep. There is deep sleep, and then there is rapid eye movement sleep where your eyes flicker to and fro, and then there is kind of light sleep. But in terms of deep sleep, which happens in the early part of your sleep cycle, it's very important for several reasons. One is an awful lot of repair goes on during deep sleep. We know during deep sleep you produce, for example, growth hormone. Deep sleep is also critical for your brain because we know during deep sleep, chambers in your brain open up. It's called the glymphatic system, and fluid from your cerebrospinal fluid, it whishes and washes through your brain, and it's a bit like the dishwasher going on. It kind of cleans up, scours, gets rid of a lot of the sort of nasty toxic proteins and things that are built up during the day. So if you don't get enough deep sleep, we know that leads, unfortunately, to increased risk of things like dementia. And beyond that, deep sleep is very important for consolidating your memories. Because what happens in deep sleep is memories are shifted from short-term areas of your brain, short-term storage areas, to long-term storage. So if you don't get enough deep sleep, then you have problems with your memory. Then there is REM sleep, rapid eye movement sleep, which is associated with intense dreams. And again, it linked to memory, but one of the important things that happens during REM sleep is that you process a lot of the emotional things that go on during the day. So it is very important for your mental health, your psychological well-being. And we know if you don't get enough REM sleep, if you're kind of rudely woken up in the morning by the alarm going off, then that leaves you in a pretty lousy mood for the rest of your day. Beyond that, we know that short sleep leads to overeating, it leads to obesity, it leads to depression. And if you go chronically without sleep, then it's going to shorten your life. So pretty well every system you can imagine, including your immune system, is affected by sleep.
And there are a lot of tips and tricks in your book, but there's a lot that we need to change, perhaps about our routines, our diet, where we're sleeping, the bedroom. Of all those things, if it seem a bit daunting to do all at once, which one thing should I be doing to make sure I have good quality sleep?
I would establish a sleep routine the same time every morning, the same time every night if you can, and then stick to it. And I mean stick to it 7 days a week. So no lie-ins at the weekend. Your body loves routine, your brain loves routine. So you set a time, 7, 7:30, 8 o'clock, what it is, and you just wake up that time every day. And the first thing you do is you draw the curtains and you get a good old blast of early morning light, because the light will help to reset your internal clock. So routine is what your brain loves, what your sleep loves. And if you're struggling with insomnia, do not have that little nap during the afternoon. Do not fall asleep on the sofa, but do stick to a routine. As I said, your brain will enjoy that.